so more rotation control done standing. This is akin to the lifting the leg, watching rotation. It's akin to a Shirley Starman style, letting the leg drop out when you're laying on the table. It's about, can you rotate your legs and keep your spine in neutral? And then we'll reverse it and have you rotate your spine and keep your legs in neutral also. So we'll start with watching Falana do it correctly. She'll start with one leg rotating. She's backed up against the wall, just help stabilize her. She's monitoring her ASISs to make sure she's stable. And she's rotating one leg in, one leg out, while everything stays real stable, comes back to neutral, does the same thing on the opposite side, and all the way in. And then she'll go to neutral and she'll do both legs the same direction, again, keeping stable. So there's a major isometric or eccentric activity in the lumbars and the core, keeping it still. If she was to fail as she rotated inward, what would happen is the whole pelvis would move. So she's only going to go as far as she can before it starts to move. Okay? The next step on all of these would be to take away the stability of the wall and have her do the same thing in a slight squat standing, one leg at a time. For most people, this will be a little harder. For the rare person, it will be easier. And then one leg at a time. And then both legs. And the little bit of ratchetiness, this one's a bit of a challenge for her. Okay, that's a simple rotation control exercise. Another variation on this standing would be she would hold her legs very still and she would rotate her body, upper body, keeping her legs still. Her legs have to work to keep still. And obviously, these exercises are very akin to what happens when you vacuum, what happens when you sweep. Do you have control of your core as you're twisting? Even if you have a bad disc, you have to twist in this life, so get it under control. A little reminder that the Qigong type exercises have a lot of rotational control activities that are built into them. There is a smooth, quiet rotation of the core as the upper body is moving. We didn't emphasize extension control. We emphasized a lot of rotation control, a lot of flexion control. You want to be able to control the range of motion of all these things and keep your core stable. Thanks. I've been Mark Heller, sharing global stability. Thanks to Kinetic Control, to Chad Brenzikoffer, to Mark Comerford, and to the other incredible students and teachers of Kinetic Control for a lot of these ideas.